kind of group the kids per ability, because one team may have a kid who's on JV just because he's behind, you know, some all-star on varsity, but he may be a very talented wrestler himself. So he may go to another team and wrestle some kid who, you know, is not up to par with him. So what I do is I talk to the other coaches beforehand and we say, okay, this kid's kind of, you know, here on the talent level. We'll match him up with this kid. So that way nobody's really getting, you know, crushed too bad. And the varsity league, we're in the Passaic County League. We wrestle 8 matches in that league. It's very competitive league. We have some, you know, very talented kids in that league down in lower weights. And as those kids get older, you know, they become very competitive in that league. I actually ran into a guy who runs the league yesterday, and, you know, he was telling me what a great job we do. And, you know, he's very happy to have us in that league. We wrestle 8 matches in that league. However, we also do wrestle a lot of local matches up here. So far, we have scheduled, we have Warwick High School, Warwick Youth Wrestling, coming to our place to wrestle us. We're going to be wrestling at Sussex Vantage, both varsity and JV and novice on separate nights. We're going to Vernon to wrestle in a quad meet, which is where we'll get 3 matches in one day on a Saturday. And I've got a few more lined up. They're just, the dates aren't set yet, but all those other 3, those are all set. So not only do we wrestle the Passaic County League, but we also get matches for some of the county teams, which is always good. Just one more thing I wanted to add before we go into the Q&A is I do a lot of studying when it comes to wrestling, a lot of video watching. If I study as much in high school and college as I do now with wrestling, I'd, you know, probably work for NASA or something. But one thing I do is when I watch a lot of interviews, I notice the guys giving the interviews to these famous wrestlers and coaches, they always ask, you know, if you had any advice for a young wrestler or a high school wrestler, you know, what advice would you give them? And there's always a string of things that they mention, but the one thing they always mention is, you know, you have to set goals. So one thing I'm going to do this year on the varsity JV level is, every single kid is going to set goals both for the mat and academically. So, like we said, we want to, you know, grow the family atmosphere. Family and academics is always going to come first. So if you got homework, you better make sure you get it done before you get to practice. And you're going to have academic goals, and you're going to have goals that you want to achieve on the wrestling mat, both short-term and long-term. And I'm going to keep track of those goals and make sure they get done. Alright, so if your goal is to get straight A's by the end of the year, then whatever we can do to help you get there, we're going to help you get there. Novice level, any first and second year wrestler is going to automatically be on novice to start, regardless of their size, unless they are, you know, 120 pounds plus or 100 pounds plus, then they might practice with the JV varsity just because they might not have anybody else to wrestle with at the novice practice, and they get more out of, you know, going to JV varsity practice. As far as JV varsity practice together, so they're all gonna learn the same things, and what determines varsity is we have to have wrestle-offs before our first varsity match. So we'll have a wrestle-off, I believe we'll have at least 2 wrestle-offs throughout the season, so if anybody loses a wrestle-off and is on JV, then they have another opportunity to wrestle off again for that varsity spot. So JV varsity will be together regardless of, you know, whether they're in that varsity lineup or not. It just depends on that wrestle off, who's in the varsity lineup for those matches.